Hello friends, you are watching. This is Awesome Videos, and today we are going to solve some past year's problems for sequence and series. Okay, so from the last two lectures, we are solving the past year JEE problems of sequence and series. Last video on past year JEE problem. Okay, from tomorrow we are going to start a new chapter of mathematics. Okay, so let's see our first problem. Okay, this is asked in JEE 2016. If the sum of the first 10 terms of the series 1 3 by 5 plus this is 16 by 5 m, then m is equal to, okay, so we just have to sum up the series and equate this equal to 16 by 5 m, and then we have the answer. Okay, so let's see its solution. Now see friends, here what is given, that series of this up to 10 terms, summation of this series. Okay, so we all know that, yeah, 1 of 3 by 5, 2 2 by 5, 3 1 by 5. Okay, so if we take the LCM, then 5 into 1 plus 3, that's 8 by 5. Here 5 into 2 plus 12 by 5, that's 16 by 5. 4, that is 20 upon plus 24 by 5, up to 10 terms. Okay, just simplification. Here the fraction part of 1 is given, 1 plus 3 by 5. Okay, we can write this thing as 1 plus 3 by 5. So it is 8 by 5. Here it is 2 plus 2 by 5, it is 12 by 5. Okay, now in the denominator, 5 whole square is, we can take it as common out. Okay, so we left with 8 square plus 12 square plus 16 square plus up to 10 terms. Okay, so if for this type of question we have to find the nth term, the equation for the nth term. Okay, so how we can find out this thing? Okay, so here we all know that this is a sequence series. You can find out this by your just usually, that is, we all know that it's come out like this, into n plus 1 whole square. But if you don't get it, then you can apply the formula. Which formula? Tn is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. Simple formula. Tn is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. Here we all know that a is equal to 8, a is equal to 8, and n minus 1 into d, d is equal to 12 minus 8, that is 4. Okay, and if we evaluated, we left with 4a plus 4, 4n plus 4, then it's like this, 4 into n plus 1. Okay, and then it's whole square. So Tn, nth term is 4 into n plus 1 whole square, that is 16 into n square plus 2n plus 1. This is the nth term of this series. Okay, now but we have to find the summation, so just apply summation. Summation of sigma Tn, sigma Tn is equal to 16 into summation of whole this thing. Okay, so sigma Tn is equal to sigma n is equal to 1 to 10, because we have to find the summation up to 10 terms, into 16 into n square plus 2n plus 1. Okay, now 16 is taken out as constant, so sigma n is equal to 1 to 10 n square plus 2 as constant, sigma n is equal to 1 to 10 n, and sigma n is equal to 1 to 10 into 1. Okay, we all know that the summation, the sequence is, we taught this, I taught this in this in the topic lecture. Okay, if those students who don't know the formula, please go to the topic lectures. Sigma n is equal to 1 to n, 1 to 10 n square, sigma n square's formula, n plus 1 to n plus 1 by 6, sigma n cube formula, n square n plus 1 square by 4, and sigma n formula, n plus 1 by 2. Okay, here it's n plus 1 to n plus 1 by 6, and put n is equal to 10, then it's 10 into 11 into 21 by 6, it's 385. Okay, it's 385. Then sigma n plus 1 by 2, put n is equal to 10, so 10 into 11 by 2, it's 55. 55 into 2 plus n is equal to 10. Okay, so sigma 1 is equal to n, and put n is equal to 10. So we left with this, just sum it up and multiply this. So our answer is, the summation of the series is 16 into 505. Okay, and what is given? Given is that 8 plus 8 by 5 plus whole square plus the sum of this series is 16 into 505 by 25. Remember, we common out the 5 square for all the terms, okay? So divided by 25, and this is given equal to, this is equal to 16 by 5 into m. This is equal to 16 by 5 into m. So just equate this as 16 by 5 into m. 16 16 here cancel out, 5 and here 5, so 505 by 5, that is 101. So m is 101. Very good question, but very simple question. We just need to apply a formula, okay? So this question is asked in January 2016. Okay, let's move forward to the next question. It's asked in January 2013. Okay, so what is the question? If 10 raised to 9 plus 2 11 into 10 raised to 8 plus 3 11 square 10 raised to 7 plus up to 10 into 11 raised to 9 is equal to k into 10 raised to 9, then what is k? Okay, so this is same kind of question, but here the series is not directly given. We have to find the series and find the summation and then equate it is equal to k into 10 raised to 9 and get the value of k. Okay, but how we find the series? See friends, I take k is equal to, let k is equal to 1 here. From this, if I common out 10 raised to 9 from here and cancel out it, then k becomes 1 plus 2 11 by 10, because 10 raised to 9 divide 10 raised to 8 upon 10 raised to 9, we left with 10. So it's 11 by 10 plus 3 into 11 by 10 whole square plus up to 10 into 11 by 10 whole raised to 9. Okay, so that comes out as k. Now here you can see the sequence. You can find the sequence 1 plus 11 by 10 plus 11 by 10 whole square plus up to 11 by 10 raised to 9. But see friends, here the coefficient is also given, 2 plus 3 plus up to 9. So to remove that coefficient, I have to multiply this by 11 by 10. How? See friends, if I multiply by 11 by 10, then sequence is like this. 11 by 10 plus 2 into 11 by 10 whole square. So here 2 plus 11 by 10 whole square and this term. Now I have to subtract 2 minus 1, 1 minus 2. So I have subtract this from this. So I left with minus k by 10. So 1 minus 11 by 10, okay? Now very simple thing, 1 minus 0, first term is 0, taken this from this series, first term is 0, so 1 minus 0 is 1. Now 2 into 11 by 10 into 11 by 10, that is 1 into 11 by 10. Okay, so 3 minus 2, that is also 1. So by this thing we remove the coefficient, 3 minus 2 is 1. Similarly here 10 minus 9 is also 1, and last term is minus of this, minus 10 into 11 by 10 into 10. Okay, understand? We just step out this series by one term. 1 minus 0 is 0. 1 minus 0 is 1. 2 minus 1 of 11 by 10, it's 1 of 11 by 10. 3 minus 2 of 11 by 10 whole square is 1 of 11 by 10 whole square up to this. But here, last term is left because we step out one step. Okay, so it's like this, minus 10 into 11 by 10 whole square. Now, this is pure G. P, geometrical progression, and common ratio is 11 by 10. So we just apply the formula, minus k by 10 is equal to first term a into r raised to n. Okay, so it's apply the formula for this geometrical progression, a is 1, r is 11 by 10. So formula is a, that is 1, and r raised to n minus 1, because r is greater than 1, so r raised to n is 10 minus 1 upon r minus 1 minus this thing. Okay, so here simplify this, 11 minus 10, taking out LCM, I left with 11 minus 10, that is 1, and this 10 goes up, so it's 10 into, now for this thing you can see that it's 11 by 10 whole raised to 10. Now see friends, you all know that this 10 is go up and multiply by this, so 10 into this 10, 11 minus 10 is 1, and this 10 goes up and then multiply by this 2 terms. So 10 into 11 by 10 whole raised to 10 into minus 10, minus 10 into 11 by 10 whole raised to 10. Okay, so this thing and this thing gets cancelled out, and I left with minus 10, minus minus gets cancelled out, and k is equal to 100. Okay, this is also very good, some tricky question, but just we have to know the basic thing. To remove the coefficient, you just have to multiply by the common ratio and just subtract by taking out one step ahead. Here I don't subtract this minus this. If I do that, I don't get anything. I have to take one step ahead, put that step one step ahead, and then subtract. 1 minus 0, this minus this, this minus this, okay? Then I the coefficient is removed and I get the GP, okay? So our answer is K is equal to 100, okay? So this is the complete package of sequence and series. Please watch all the videos. If you don't understand, ask me in comments. If you have any question, ask me in comments and watch this video again and again. These are 100% asked in examination, minimum one question or and maximum two question. Okay, so thank you for watching this video. If you like this, don't forget to share it and hit that subscribe button.